How you feeling, Joseph?
Feeling freaking good.
Hey guys, and welcome back. I wanted to let you guys know that we are in a new location this week. This week we are over on the coast of Pismo Beach. My wife and I decided to take a vacation, so mom and dad had their trailer taken over to Pismo Coast Village. It's an amazing little getaway. Anyways, I wanted to break down some visual suggestions for you today. I know that we've talked a little bit in the past about verbal suggestions and post-hypnotic techniques, but I wanted to talk to you today about visual suggestions. I wanted to be able to break that down. So I'm gonna pull up a video that I've taken of a previous client. This is a guy that was a professor at three different universities. Really, really nice guy. His name's Joseph. So you may be hearing me use his name throughout the video. Either way, I'm gonna let you see exactly what's going on, and then I'm gonna break down why I'm doing it and how I'm doing it. So stay tuned. Now, Joseph, when you've done enough for now, and you know you've done enough, at your time, at your pace, I just want you to open your eyes and feel absolutely incredible. Yeah? How'd you get on?
Well, that was amazing.
Yeah.
Feel really good.
Good.
Yeah. Strong stuff.
Yeah. Did you end up anything, feeling anything? Sensations, emotions?
Feeling. Sensations, yes. Felt strong, empowered.
Yeah.
Emotions just felt free in the moment. Yeah.
Yeah. You feel like you're able just to kind of pull the top off of that and just begin to let all that negativity. See, so this is one of those visual suggestions that's just absolutely brilliant. What you're doing is you're engaging the subconscious and you're telling them that you're able to take off the top and you're able to let all those emotions come up. So we just previously had done an emotional detox. It's where you talk about the fights of life, the feelings, images, thoughts, emotions, or sensations. And all of those things are able to bubble up or able to float up, dissipate up, however you want to say it. And what we're doing here is we're engaging the subconscious. We're letting them know that we are still in the process of letting all that up. So even after I've asked him to open his eyes are open. He's still there. He still understands what's happening, but he's still in hypnosis. He's still under the suggestion that there's still going to be some stuff that's going to be coming up. Negativity just kind of dissipate upwards.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Felt like it was being taken out right out of my body.
So any negative things that have just kind of popped up, in other words, what I'm looking for is for your subconscious to say, here, I've got these issues right here and I need to deal with these. So on to the second visual suggestion. I was talking to Joseph and I mentioned that there are these issues and I pointed at these issues. I'm cueing into his subconscious that I'm looking for certain issues. I'm looking for those negative things. It is a very visual suggestion, but it is also followed by the voice that there are issues, and I want to touch these. These are the ones that I want to focus on. Anything pop up?
Yep. Yeah, felt like the tension and the nerves and the anxiety of what I get when I just leave the house these days and just feel like extra, like hypersensitive around people and whatnot.
Go ahead and open your eyes and just look at me. You feel all that tension begin to kind of just tease out.
All right, so this suggestion was actually really, really straightforward. I'm talking about his neck and how I'm teasing the muscles out. He was talking about that when he gets really anxious, he can feel his neck just tighten up. And so I was showing him that you can tease that out. You can pull it out. So you're able just to relax. The really cool thing is if you look really, really closely at the video, it really starts to wobble. It shows you just how powerful I am.
You don't feel it anymore, just kind of pulling off. You feel that now, even as you're looking at me, that I'm able to just kind of pull that off of you, that it's not that tension that was around you. I'm just being able to pull that off of you right now. You feel that?
Mm-hmm.
Good. How do you feel now?
Powerful, strong.
Yeah. Good deal. Mm-hmm. So we're going to put you in one more time. And this time we're going to put in all sorts of really good, powerful stuff. How's that sound?
It sounds perfect.
Yeah. So all I want you to do is just look at my finger. And as it comes closer,
all right, so here we start with another hypnotic induction. I'm talking about the finger going towards the eyes. He's already in hypnosis. Really, this is just the experience. I'm not really putting him back into hypnosis. He's already there. And so all I'm doing is I'm just saying, and then right here, when you look at this finger, you're gonna feel as if though your eyes are just getting heavier, and I just bring them closer to him. All it is giving him a focal point so that he's able to focus his eyes on it. His eyes get tired, and so he's just allowing himself to sink back down into his hypnosis. That's all it is. It's just another form of induction.
Your eyes are just going to begin to feel heavier and heavier. And when it gets to the place that they're just too heavy to even manage to keep open, just go ahead and close them. Just allow them to close. There you go. Let your eyes close. How you feeling, Joseph?
Feeling freaking good.
Yeah. Feeling calm and confident, huh?
Calm and confident. Yep.
Fantastic, man. Fantastic. Anything else come up for you? Or was that good?
It was really good. Felt free, literally free of every inhibition that I've previously had, and just body felt free to do what it wanted to do.
Fantastic. So now just remember, for the next couple of days, the next couple of weeks, the next couple of months, this is not just a this moment happening.
All right, so in this next clip, I'm gonna be talking about a few different things. I'm just talking to Joseph. Our session is pretty much over, and now it's just the kind of post-hypnotic little things that I'm dropping off to him. I'm mentioning that it's not gonna be in just this moment. I'm saying that it's gonna carry on with you. I say that he's gonna feel free. And I say that also it's like you're laying down some great weights. So you'll hear all those things, but it's also the visual aspect that really kind of nails it home. It's not just something that you just hear, but you're also able to see it. So it's able to kind of connect at a deeper level with the subconscious.
This is going to carry on with you. So you're going to notice the next couple of days, the next couple of weeks, the next couple of months, you're just going to be feeling more and more free. It's going to be, it's really going to shock you at just how much you've been having to be able to just lay down. I know that when I first started doing hypnosis and I started feeling stuff, it's like my personality almost like shifted and I felt more like myself. Does that make sense? Mm. So the next couple of days, weeks, you're just gonna start feeling like, man, I'm more like myself, more like I don't have to perform a certain way. I don't have to be a certain way. I can be me. And that's where you're going to find yourself. Yeah?
Yes.
All right.
100%.
Good deal. So just be aware, Joseph, that for the next couple of days, there may be a couple of things that may pop up for you. You may experience a little bit of a brain fog. This is just your brain kind of like resorting things away.
All right, so this part is, it's not really a post-hypnotic suggestion. It's not really a visual suggestion. It's really just kind of explaining to him that after you had a really, really good session, your brain is just kind of doing these funky things and you just kind of feel like you want to be by yourself. You don't want to be bothered. And really what's happening is your brain is sorting everything back to where it's supposed to be. See, what happens is that we live life in such a way that we kind of just push things off. We just kind of suppress things and we stop paying attention to the things that are really bothering us. And so they get like misfiled at times. And so what happens is after a really good session, just like I will mention, there is that snow globe effect that everything's being shaken up and it just takes some time for everything to kind of settle. So it is a very direct suggestion, but it's also just a huge explanation of what he's going to be encountering in the next couple of days, weeks, and potentially months.
Basically, you have like a snow globe effect. We shook everything up, and so things are just kind of settling into where they're supposed to be settling. So that's what's going to be happening for the next couple of days. So if you wake up and you're just like, man, I feel great, but I just don't feel like being around people, that's okay. Okay?
Definitely understand, yeah.
Good deal. Any questions for me?
None. That was fantastic.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, man. Well, I'm going to be checking in with you again in about 2 weeks just to make sure that everything's kind of settled and everything's kind of worked itself out. Just let me know. And you have my number. If something else comes up, just holler.
All right. So to wrap up the rest of this video, I just want to give a huge shout out to my professor friend, Joseph. Hey, thanks for coming along for the ride. And if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, drop them down in the comment section down below. Any gripes, moans, complaints, you can keep those to yourself. And for that, catch you in the next one. I wasn't even recording that whole time. I wasn't even recording.